welcome back. Kid Charlemagne is this week's solo lesson. Super fun, challenging solo. A lot of good stuff in here. Not for the faint, definitely an intermediate to advanced level piece of music. Nothing super speedy in the chops department, but just a lot of times you'll find it difficult to just get the note or to get the melody line. The way it's constructed is very very creative and very challenging at the same time. Lots of little musical meals in this one. So let's get into it. Welcome back to Kid Charlemagne. Now, what I'm gonna do with this solo, just due to the complexity of it, is I'm gonna go under the assumption that anybody trying to tackle this solo is already a fairly good guitar player. I mean, you'd have to be, or incredibly ambitious to wanna take something like this on. Now, the reason I'm gonna make these assumptions is I don't wanna go through like I tend to do and tell you, all right, this finger with this fret, and that sort of thing, because the lesson is going to end up being about 45 minutes of me kind of doing that. And it's going to get really, really kind of drawn out, too drawn out, I feel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play each of the phrases slowly. And if there's something to mention about the phrase, then I'm going to mention it. And I think that that'll keep us on course. Okay, so our first section sounds like this. So what we got there is a unison bend, and then you release the bend and pull off, and then you pick the 7th fret on the D string. Then you have a very quick bend, release, bend, hold, release, and then some vibrato. Keep in mind with vibrato is you want Larry Carlton vibrato, you don't want Angus Young vibrato. Like real fast, intense. You want nice, slow, smooth, you know, mellow. No, well, not necessarily mellow, but he's got a certain touch to his vibrato. You want to try to emulate those things as well. Okay, next piece. And a little slower. Nothing special there. Just remember with your slide, gotta find a nice way. I wouldn't shift the whole hand. I would try to push from the thumb and return. That will help you quite a bit. And I would slide with the middle to kind of line your first finger up. Okay. Next piece. So here I'm using exclusively my first and third fingers. Tab is available at walkerguitar.com. That'll make your life a whole lot easier. Okay, and then after that phrase, you have a little add-on. A little E minor sort of lick. Okay, next piece, and we move. So this is tricky. Since there's vibrato on it and my pinky is too stumpy to do the vibrato, I tend to use my third finger on that final note. The structure of this lines up as 14, 15, 17. You're sliding from 12 to 14. There's a lot of string skipping in this, in the solo, generally speaking, as well. Okay? Then you get a little, that's fun. It's a pre-bend from 17, release, just a lot of hopping around. You really want to get good at your first finger rolling from string to string, rolling it from one note and rolling to an adjacent string and losing the previous note in trade for the new note, so you don't hear them both together. That's really going to clean up your playing as well. Now we have a busy run. Now slowly, sliding from 14 with my middle finger. That's the first half. Oops. Haven't used my third finger. Next part. Again on the second half. That's a little B minor shape, by the way. Little bend. Full step, release, kind of choke it off. Return with a little vibrato. Now he comes down to the fifth position. And slowly, so again, that's got a similar shape as one of the licks that we did earlier in the solo. Half step, release. Or sorry, choke it off and then come back to seven. Slide. Come right down a D minor shape. Pinky grabs 10. Middle finger grabs 8 on the B. Arguably the funnest part of the song. There's a few, but it's one of my favorites. This is arguably the hardest part of the song. You're going to slide with your third finger from 7 to 10 on the D. The middle finger ends up getting anchored at the 9th fret on the G string as a pivot note. And you have to actually work your way up with the first fingers and the third fingers on the B string and then the E string. Oops. Can't go so slow. I just feel, yeah, it's strange. And then you end it with 12 on the B and 13. Now, a personal note on this, he's not doing this. Sounds really, really sloppy. You don't want to anchor that middle finger on that ninth fret note. You have to actually subtly release the pressure of that finger. Really tricky. It took me a long time to get my finger disciplined enough to be able to do that. But that's what's necessary, or all the notes are going to bleed together and it's just going to sound muddy. Learning the solo gives you a much deeper appreciation for Larry Carlton and these kind of guys, that you just realize how much control they have over the guitar. It's phenomenal. It's amazing. And actually, while I'm rambling about things, I watched an interview and he said that, to his recollection, he did this solo in 2 takes. So somewhere there's a cut in the solo, but he was more or less familiar with the song and he just laid down an improv. And they did it twice. And it was done, and he went home. And that was the solo. Insane! Insane! Okay, moving on. Now I have this interesting little lick. And the way I handle this, it's very symmetrical, actually. In its asymmetric... is asymmetrical. It's symmetrical in not being symmetrical. You're going, you get this little thing. Okay. Now we have some good stuff for the first finger with kind of navigating adjacent strings. So we're going sliding into the fifth position. So 5 to 7. Rolling on the third and the second strings. Pulling off. And then sliding up another whole step with the same finger on the D string. A little baby G chord for those interested. Remember, you don't want to go, you don't want the whole thing, you want it note by note, which means you really got to discipline your touch. Nothing too special on this, but there's no vibrato on that note, which is good news, but you do hold it. Whole step bend. And that's a very quick hammer, that final note. Oh, next piece. Got that little thing, 7th fret. Remember, you're not, you don't want to ever hear both. You have to get very good at kind of rocking on and off of the notes you want. Okay, so that part. Sorry, I messed that ending up. It's and the next piece. So that's a pre-bent note. Pull off, and you gotta roll that first finger onto the G string at the same time you're trying to hold that note to the very last moment. Sorry, my bends are sloppy today. And you're trying to go up a half step as you do that. Jeez, don't listen to me. Okay. And the final piece, whole step bend, you actually tap the 14th fret, this is the G string, then you pull off with the same finger, then release the bend. And he does a little vibrato on that by actually tapping and kind of shaking. It's hard to do it slowly. And then you pull off. So after that tap, you don't pick a single note. It's like a hand, it's all in the fingers there. So let's do the whole thing now. hope you enjoyed Kid Charlemagne. I sure did. I still revisit the solo just for fun. It's all in all, I'd say it's one of the greatest solos ever made for guitar. I love it. I love the way it feels under your fingers once you know, you really start to get it. And there's always some kind of challenge where you're just, for me, you're right at the cusp of almost losing it, you know, and that feels really good in some respects. So you know, I hope you feel the same. Anyway, stay tuned for more awesome stuff on Walker Guitar. My name's Corey, and I'll see you soon. Take care.